العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله ذي القدرة والنعم ذي الفضل والكرم الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you will believe, fear Allah as you should be feared, and they not accept on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya arhamar rahimeen, ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fussilat, reporting for us the disbeliever and their talk about the Quran. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and the disbelievers, those who are objecting and showing their enmity and fighting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. Don't listen to this book. Don't listen to his recitation of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ, while he's reciting, just talk randomly and in a way to distract people to don't listen to it. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ, that you may have the upper hand, that you may overcome. And here, subhanAllah, in this ayah, the khasm, the one who's really the big enemy, it is the Qur'an. It's the Qur'an, by himself. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the one who's reciting, but they're concerning the Qur'an, and the fact that the Qur'an was revealed, they were already defeated. By the revelation of the Qur'an, they lost and they are defeated. Because they said, do not listen to it, talk randomly while the recitation is being recited, that you may have the upper hand. So it's like they've already been defeated by the existence of the Qur'an. And this is, ikhwani, akhawati, is a reflection on reviving the value of the Qur'an in our heart and our soul when we are, masha'Allah and insha'Allah, welcoming the coming of Ramadan, the month of the Qur'an. It is the month of the Qur'an to recite only the Qur'an, or it is the month of the Qur'an just to look in the book of the Qur'an. Because the Qur'an by itself is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who chant the course of the whole universe. And this is for the believer to renew the oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the constitution that he sent down subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Qur'an. وَقَالُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. Don't listen. It's like magic. But what is the magic in the Qur'an? And it's been from that time to this present time, those enemy and the army and the soldier of the evil doing the same thing for the Qur'an. As it's been reported in the beginning of the century, the 20th century, the minister of the British colonies saying, our problem is the Qur'an. We cannot have the upper hand of the Muslim society until or unless we rip off the Qur'an, we tear off the Qur'an. One of the attendees, he stood and he has a book, and this is in the history, and he tore off the Qur'an. He told them, this is not the way, this is the way of being dumb if you do such a thing. Tear off the Qur'an from the heart of the Muslim. That's what we need to do, by distracting them and pushing away from the book of Allah. And the same one with the same position, who is the minister of the French colonies, when he didn't find any way to turn the Algerian, those great people, to be like them Christian. And when he's been blamed about that, he said, what do you want me to do? Why you blame me? their Quran is greater and more powerful than the whole press. It is the Quran, which through the Quran and through the saying of these people and the enemy of the Quran and the army of the evil, the Muslim should sense back the greatness of this book. It's not only words to be recited. It's not only to look at it or to recite it to gain reward. It is how you make the Quran your way of life. And one of the things that is amazing there, which has become for us something that we don't even know, we don't even talk about the gift that we have. If you look at your brother in next to you, you remind yourself this great gift that is coming from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They've been amazed how you find the unity of masha'ar. Emotion are the same from people coming from Asia, in India, and in Africa, and in Europe. They have the same feeling. And the same feeling is extracted from a book that is language is for the majority of the Muslims is a foreign language. This unity of masha'ar, wahdatul masha'ir bi kitabin wahid, is amazing. We don't see it. But it is what for the army of the evil, they look at for us to remind ourselves the greatness of this book. And in the coming of Ramadan, to reflect back in the meaning of the value of the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the disbelievers, they understood listening to the Quran is a threat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, listening to the Quran is your way to rahmah. وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. السماع الاستماع والإنصات. الاستماع to hear, to listen with reflection, to hear with your heart, to hear very attentive and listen to the Quran. And what is the difference between استمع وأنصت? أنصت is to hold yourself in peace, to not talk, to not be distracted. So it's like you hold yourself in peace and mindful and concentrated. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. We have sent down this book full of life, full of blessing, for people of understanding, they reflect on the ayat of the Quran. And look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when you hear the recitation of the Quran, listen attentively to it. Put your heart in it and keep yourself in, hold yourself into peace. That's the way how you're going to be showered with the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, very clearly show us the path of the mercy. And the ayah before it, what he said, because the disbelievers, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ وَإِذَا لَمْ تَأْتِهُمْ بِهَايَةً قَالُوا لَوْلَا جَتَبَيْتَهَا. If you don't bring them a miracle, they say, if you make up a miracle, just show us that you are the Prophet of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَتَّبِعُ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. I'm only following what is being revealed to you. هَذَا بَصَائِرُ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is our clear proofs from your Lord and our guidance and mercy for people who believe and who have faith. And when you see this, the ayah that comes after it, that Allah calling us, listen to the book of Allah. Reflect on the book of Allah. You're going to see this clear evidence. You're going to see the guidance. You're going to see the light. It is, subhanAllah, the soul. It is the light. It is the life. It is the book of Allah. It is the word of Allah. And when we're thinking of that, if only the rahmah coming through the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how come someone will desert the book of Allah? When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one of the narration in the book of the tafsir explaining the ayah in Surah Al-Furqan, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying, my Lord, Ya Allah, my people, they've forsaken this Qur'an. They've taken it like a thing forsaken. They deserted the Qur'an. And in one of the narrations say that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying this in the Day of Judgment. Because the majority of those who are saying they are Muslim, they are thrown from the path. They're not going to make it. Why? Because they turn back to the Qur'an, to the gift, to the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. How they deserted it. We have a lot of reciters today. We have a lot of people who memorize the Quran. We have a lot of people and schools, mashallah, of the Quran. But how can be the Quran deserted when we have this much number of those reciters? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال لا تقوم الساعة حتى يكثر القراء ويقل العلماء. It's a sign of the day of judgment that we have a lot of reciters, but a few of those who are knowledgeable. It's a sign. So we should not be like really in a way cheerful to see all this. It's a great thing, but we need to correct the way how to look at the Quran. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كما قالت السيدة عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, كان القرآن يمشي. The Prophet was an embodiment of the Quran. He used the Quran who walks. Therefore, the Quran to be only recitation without implementing it in the life of the believer, if without implementing it in the way of life of the believer, it will be, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Bani Israel, كَالْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَسْفَارَ. It's like the donkey, he's carrying a heavy load. He doesn't know what he's carrying. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it to us in the Quran to warn us, not to criticize or to mock others. We believer who do not mark, we always reflecting ourselves to do not make the same mistake, so we avoid the curse of Allah and the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to descend on us. Therefore, the embodiment of the Quran is how to reflect and to get the Quran as to translate the Quran in our life. And this is opportunity, ya ikhwan. To make Ramadan is a great opportunity of reflection and reviewing the way of life with the Quran. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He complimented those who memorized the Quran, قال بل هو آيات بينات في صدور الذين أوتوا العلم. There are clear verses, آيات of Allah and signs of Allah in the heart of those who have knowledge. Those who have knowledge, they know what to do with the Quran. Therefore, the reflection in the Quran to translate the value of the Quran in the life comes before memorizing it. Comes before the much recitation without reflecting in it. Because the reflection, it is the produce. It is the result of what the message of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to us. It is the message that the evil or the army of evil is threatening them. How come the unity only comes from the Quran? And if such a unity happens, it's only a threat for those who are following their whims. Because if the Muslims are united, if the whole justice will spread all around, iwallah, if the whole justice, and let the history speak. Go and read the history. The rahmah and the justice spread in Andalusia and all over the Muslim world. Just have the history to read. So those who only read the Quran based on their whims is a threat for them. Why? Because like the people of Quraysh, they saw that they're gonna lose the power who make only war and only serve their interest. When in the Quran, in the book of the guidance, the Quran has been narrated, لَا تَنْقَضِي عَجَائِبُهُ. His amazing and astonishing gems never come to end. فِيهِ خَبَرُ مَنْ قَبْلَكُمْ وَنَبَأُ مَنْ بَعْدَكُمْ. It has the news of the people before you. It's giving you life, and it has the news of everything is going to come. He is the Quran, man ibtagha min ghayrihi al-huda dhal. Whoever who seek guidance beside the Quran, he going to lead himself astray. Innahu hablullahi al-mateen wa dhikru al-hakeem wa siratu mustaqeem. It is the strong rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the all wise reminder. It is the right path. It is the right path. Whoever who seeks the right path or any path beside the Quran, he will not find the way. He will find himself, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, in the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the beauty of the Quran. It is the word of Allah. And when you read the Quran, what you find in it is just in a small summary. To see the greatness of the book of Allah is not words that we recite just who want to complete the Quran and make khatmah. When you make khatmah, it's a blessing. But what you get from those khatmah, what you get in new value in your life, what you get in new words in your speech, what you get in your way how you walk, a new way of behavior. If the Quran changed the way you walk, the way you eat, you will talk to people. That is the value of the Quran to implement in the life of the believer. When you look at the Quran, you find a great thing. You find the nature that is around us is not your enemy. Today we have a big storm, everyone is scared because it might be taking everything. You find a full harmony between you, your action, and the whole universe. Everyone is celebrating praise to Allah. You find it in the Quran. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ وَالنُّجُومُ وَالْجِبَالُ وَالشَّجَرُ وَالدَّوَابُ. Everything, the sun, the stars, everything prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a group of the people, you are joining this universe in the prayers to Allah. And you see in the Quran that this universe or this existence that we are in is not restricted in the land that our Muslim brother or sister, they live into restricted land where the oppressor thinking that they are controlling their sustenance. They see in the Quran that everything belongs to Allah, that the journey of the human being will not stop at death because death is the beginning of the life. That's age in the Quran. And that's how the believer, when he read the Quran, all his aspects of thinking, of life, of feeling, it's changing when he read the Quran. He read in the Quran that the dignity and the honor doesn't come with the color, doesn't come with the money, doesn't come with the power, the dignity and the honor because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your Lord. You see the honor and the dignity when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you read, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ صَوَرْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمْ. We have created you, and then we have fashioned you, and then we said to the angel to prostrate to your father. You'll be prostrate too, as the honor of the creation of Allah, as the honor to be the vicegerent on earth, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilling the will and the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You'll be dignified, and you have this honor that everything be subjected to you, everything is serving you. أَلَمْ تَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make everything in the heaven and the earth to serve you? He make the cattle to carry you, He make the sea to carry you. وَحَمَلْنَا ابْنَ آدَمَ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. This is when you read the Quran, you're not nobody. You are the human being, believer who prostrate to Allah. You are honored and dignified. You are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remember you when you remember Him. You are the one that the angel be prostrate to you. You are the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathe the soul, the great soul into our bodies to become these people, to become these dignified people. Therefore you find in the Quran totally different value. Totally different value. And you find in the Quran that nothing can happen by coincidence. Everything in the hand of Allah. We should give you security, we should give you safety, we should give you the belief that the promise of Allah is the promise of the truth. وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدْرٍ. And one of the poets of Islam, رحمه الله تعالى, philosopher and poet, Muhammad Iqbal, he was saying poet about this. وَيَقُولُ الصِّينُ لَنَا وَالْعُرْبُ لَنَا وَالْهِنْدُ لَنَا وَكُلُّ لَنَا. Everyone who is Muslim, he's a Chinese Muslim, he's my brother. Arab Muslim, he's my brother. Indian Muslim, he's my brother. Everyone Muslim, he's my brother. وَأَضْحَى الْإِسْلَامُ دِينُنَا. And the Islam is our way. وَالْكَوْنُ كُلُّهُ وَطَنُنَا. And the whole universe, all of it, is our native land. Every piece in the universe belongs to Allah. Therefore, you join this piece of the universe in celebrating Allah. Every piece in the universe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes observant to you. And this is the dignity and the honor that you see in the Quran. ثُمَّ أَقُولُ وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةُ التَّوْحِيدِ لَنَا نُورًا وَأَعْدَدْنَا لَهَا أَرْوَاحُنَا لَهَا سَكَنًا. And the word of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah made it to be our light and will prepare our soul to be the home of this word of Tawheed. This is the beautiful word from the poet, rahimahullah ta'ala, philosopher Muhammad Iqbal, to see the value that we need to bring back in our mind, a value that we need to think of when this coming of Ramadan, to have a new awakening of the system of worship, to have a new oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because today, the Muslims, they need a whole revival of their deen, a whole revival of their thinking. It's not about reciting words, it's about expressing those words in our life. That is the way of the Quran. When in the beginning, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has al-Aqaba al-Ula, he met 12 people from the Ansar, 12 of the companions. And they gave him their pledge on a very simple, basic and fundamental of Islam. Do not associate a partner with Allah. Do not steal. Do not kill your children. Do not make zina. And fulfill and obey Allah, His Messenger. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent with them Mus'ab ibn Umayr. Mus'ab ibn Umayr, 12 from the Ansar with Mus'ab ibn Umayr, that he was living with As'ad ibn Zurara radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And Mus'ab ibn Umayr for less than a year was teaching the values of the Quran. Less than a year teaching the values of the Quran in Medina. Before the coming of the next Hajj, the majority of people of Medina, few of them from the Munafiq or Mushrikeen, but the whole people of Medina with their leader Sa'd ibn Mu'adh or Usayd ibn Khudayr standing, they say, to when we go to leave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being chased in the mountain of Mecca. We need to give him, bring, get him here. When they went in the Al-Aqaba Thaniya and the second, there were 70 men and 2 women, and they give their pledge to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam not to do hold themselves on sins. They give their pledges to give their life for the Prophet, to give their life for Allah. قَالَ تَمْنَعُونَنِي مِمَّا تَمْنَعُونَ مِنْهُ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ. Will you protect me from everything, from what you protect yourself and your money and your family? And they give the pledge to give their life. What happened in less than a year? What made the hearts of the Ansar that didn't know Islam in less than a year? It is the power of the Quran. It is the mother of the Quran that you come. We need to bring this value of the greatness of the Quran, ya akhwan. It's not about how many rewards you are collecting when you are reading. It's about what you're going to change in your life. The beauty of the Quran, the gems of the Quran, and the Quran has power in all the senses. يقول in the narration, هو الذي حين انتهت الجن من سماعه قالوا إنا سمعنا قرآنا عجبا. In the one, when the jinn, they finished from listening to it, they said, we heard an amazing recitation, an amazing content, an amazing guidance, an amazing life, an amazing life that in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down in Laylatul Qadr. And we have, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yubalighuna Laylatul Qadr. We want, inshaAllah, if Allah gift us with Laylatul Qadr, to bring this meaning and the value of the Quran to understand and to change the way of the life of the believer, our condition of life, our family, our community that is based on life, on guidance, on soul, and on happiness, and on justice, and the power of the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the story of Sulaiman, and Sulaiman said to the people around him in his meeting, قَالَ مَنْ يَأْتِينِ بِعَرْشِهَا, who can bring me the throne of Balqis, the queen of Balqis? قَالَ عِفْرِيتٌ مِنَ الْجِنِّ أَنَا آتِيكَ بِهِ. Ifrit, one of the big, strong among the jinn, he said, I will carry it to you. وَإِنِّي عَلَيْهِ لَقَوِيٌّ أَمِينٌ. I have the power to do it. Allah give them power to do such a thing. He said, I will bring it to you because before you finish or you complete your meeting. قَالَ الَّذِي عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْكِتَابِ. The one who had the knowledge of the words of Allah. He's a righteous man. You can look at it, maybe he's weak, but his heart is so powerful because Allah is with him. قَالَ أَنَا آتِيكَ بِهِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَرْتَدَّ إِلَيْكَ طَرْفُكَ. That's the power of the Qur'an. He said, I'll bring it to you before you blink your eye. What did he say? He just implored Allah, supplicate with the great name of Allah. He said, Ya Allah, bring the throne by your word, by your power. عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْكِتَابِ. And Sulaiman was amazed, how can this happen? It is the power of the word of Allah, if you just befriend to the word of Allah. It is the power of the word of Allah, when you realize that Allah is speaking to you when you read the Quran. Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl, Ikrimah, Sahabiyun Jaleel, his father is the head of the ignorance and kufr. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get out alive from dead people, from the kufr, Allah get out iman. عكرمة ابن أبي جهل, he used to read the Quran. After he read it, he closed the mushaf, he held it tight, and he would be crying very hard tears. يقول كلام ربي. This is the words of Allah. Do you understand? This is the word of Allah. You're kissing the words of Allah. It's the words of Allah. Imagine someone has a letter for someone dear, he always, every time, or after a while, he'll open it and he'll look at this letter reading to remember the greatness and the love that he has this person. You have the words of the King of the Kings, subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put in our heart the love of the Quran and to change our life according to the values of the Quran and to make us understand the greatness of Quran. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى. أما بعد, الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة يونس, يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. All mankind, a true reminder came to you from your Lord and a healing in what in the heart, this is Allah saying, and a guidance and a mercy for the people who believe. This is, it is a healing for our hearts. It is a healing for our chest. It's a great reminder. It's a guidance and a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the narration being said that Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, and also that Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, and this is, it might be harsh, but it is a reminder for all of us. قَالَ إِلْتَمِسْ قَلْبَكَ فِي ثَلَاثَةِ مَوَاضِعَ. Seek your heart in three state, in three position. Seek your heart if it's alive or not when you listen and you recite the Quran, when you pray to Allah, when you are by yourself. Three position. When you listen to the Quran, where's your heart is? When you pray, where your heart is? Is present with Allah or distracted and traveled away? When you are alone. And in another narration, the third one, when you listen about death, how it is the state of your heart. And the difficult part, if you don't feel your heart in this three position, then you do not have a heart. فَلْتَمِسْ لَكَ قَلْبَهَا. If you don't feel anything in this position, so we do not have heart. That's why this is an opportunity, Akhwan. Ramadan is an opportunity of reviewing ourselves, of correcting our path, or renewing the path and the oath with Allah, and building from today a pure, inshaAllah, fresh heart to be present in the Quran, present in the Salah, present in the reminder. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and yuhabbib ilayna al-imana wa yuzayyinahu fi qulubina. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يكره لنا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم وبلغنا رمضان يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين. واذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم, ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقيموا الصلاة يرحمكم الله.